Welcome to Watch of the Week on Caseback. This is a series of brief reviews of recently introduced timepieces. It's not a commercial, it's not paid content. You will hear my unfiltered opinion about certain watches. And our guest today is... I know the price is not really in our reach, and I think I can say this for the majority of the viewers, but this watch has something so special that we should ignore the 38K for a few minutes. This watch has a complication I've never seen before, and so I want to share my excitement here. And I think we all can learn something from this piece without buying it. First, what means Portuguesa or Portuguese? Well, it means that 1939, two tradesmen from Portugal asked IWC if the company could produce a large wristwatch with the precision of a pocket watch. Because IWC was famous in those days for ultra-precise pocket watches. By the standards back then, of course. And so the company put the pocket watch caliber 74 in a 41.5 millimeter big case. And this passes for normal today, but back then most watches for men were under 34 millimeters small. The dial of the new watch was inspired by the watches IWC produced back then for the British Royal Navy, and so a Portuguese watch had always a drop of salt water in the design. And the watch then was a commercial disaster. Until the 1970s, they sold only about 690 pieces of the watch. And now it's a classic. Yeah, history makes strange turns sometimes. By the way, until today, it's unclear why those Portuguese gentlemen wanted their watch so big. And I think the reason is that they just wanted the pocket watch caliber, and that happened to be huge. And now IWC introduced some new Portuguese watches, and one caught my attention because it shows the tide. It shows the moon and the tide. But first, let's go over the basics. We have an automatic watch. The case is 18 karat 5N gold, which is rose gold, but IWC likes to call it 5N gold. The height is 14.4 millimeters. It comes with sapphire crystal with anti-reflective coating on both sides. The dial is blue, beautiful dark blue. Hands are gold plated. 18 karat gold appliques on the dial. Water resistant is 6 bars. This sounds strange for a watch which is designed for service on a yacht, but first, it's not really for that because of the price, and second, if you're on a boat and your watch comes in contact with more than 60 meters of water, then it's not the watch which ruins your day. Movement is the IWC in-house caliber 82835 with a frequency of 28,800, 22 jewels, 60 hour power reserve. And now, finally, let's speak about the complication. The thing shows the perpetual moon phase for the northern and southern hemisphere. And it indicates spring tide or neap tide. And I'm not exactly sure how to read it, to be frank. I think you need a manual at the beginning. But I just love that they display the moon tide connection with a watch. Because we've learned in school that the moon's gravity pulls the water in a certain direction, which results in tides. And I think wearing that piece would give us some sort of scientific feel. And the watch, I don't know how to describe this. It looks mysterious and wise at the same time. I just love that combination. And worth mentioning is also the combination of all those materials. I mean, see the strap here. They combine that luxurious piece with a blue rubber strap with textile inlay so that your skin is not in contact directly with the rubber. And for me, this works. Strange, but it works. I mean, we've seen this on the Rolex Rose Gold Yachtmaster, but here, in my opinion, it looks more organic. And the watch is not available, but you can pre-order it now. So let's hope for a miracle on our bank accounts this year. Okay, and that's all I wanted to share with you. See you next Monday to Watch of the Week on Caseback.